Hi, Megan here, and I'm capturing how we take a photo from a photo shoot on an iOS device to prepping it for our social media and Shopify site. So the first step is converting the file type. iOS automatically creates this generic image name with a number. And then it has a .HEIC, I'm going to call it HEIC, file type. And unfortunately, we can't open that file type in our other systems. So, what I have enabled for Mustard Seed Training is this app called the HEIC View Image Viewer Decoder. So, if you are not in our in Mustard Seed Training and you want to find this app, you can click Connect More Apps and search for HEIC, and this will be one of just a couple options that comes up. So I right-clicked on the image name, open with, and open it in the Image Viewer Decoder. Now this takes a few seconds for it to process the image, so this is a great time to say a little prayer or look out the window, stretch your arms. All right, so I noticed that the original default when I first started this was fit to page width, so my images looked really giant, and so I changed it to fit to page size, and now every time I open a file, it automatically fits it to page size. So I take a quick look at the image and decide if it's one I want to keep or not. So some of these photos from the photo shoot are duplicates, and I don't want to process all of them. Ultimately, from each photo shoot or product, we're going to ultimately get it down to one main photo, and for a social media story or something, or a idea pin, they're looking at three or five photos ultimately. So I take a quick look, say, is this one I want to keep? And the default here is for it to save as the to convert it from the HEIC to a JPEG. Another option is a PNG, which is a smaller file, but that also makes the colors a little less vibrant. So we're going to stick with this default. Click Save. And our next step here, I already have a folder on my local computer where I'm going to save this. And the last step here is to write the file name using descriptive words. So search engines actually look at the name of the image to, when people go into a search engine and they're looking for a green chasuble, let's say, or sewing books, I don't know. Then if our image file name is descriptive, it'll much more easily pull that image in their search results. So this is, I already processed several of these from the photo shoot. So I called it AMD for Anne Marie Darby, Smile and Snow. And so I'll pause now. That's enough to save it.